Hello, miss.
Hi.
Picking up a load.
Fill that paper out right there.
Which one? The white one?
White, pink, and yellow.
Pick up number. Can you take a look if you need more than that?
It was canceled order.
Canceled order?
Yes, so you need to call your dispatcher to see if you're picking something else up.
Okay.
It was canceled yesterday.
We always have problems. So guys, how that goes, and the load, it's canceled from yesterday. I'm not sure whose fault is yet, but we are 200 miles down from LA, next to the border on I-8 here. That's kind of bad, because I was hoping we're gonna have this nice load. It didn't work for me. Okay, let's talk about what's going on with market and what they decide to do with the employees, right? I was dealing with this lady here, and I saw this news, guys. CH Robinson, they lay over 1,000 to 1,200 people. Don't be scared, drivers, because that will go more management, because people starting cutting their expenses in the office.
COVID lockdowns, China, I don't know, we can't figure out what they're doing to their economy or their people. That's for them to decide. But the rates that you're getting, I mean, have crashed, right? One to 2K in what used to be 20,000?
Yeah, there's no question, Brian. First off, great to be here. But we've seen significant changes, specifically in the global forwarding part of our business, in terms of the economics of moving goods on a global basis, whether it be in the Trans-Pacific, you know, to the West Coast. That's clearly the area where we've seen the biggest downturn in terms of pricing. I guess the good news for consumers and for businesses is that there's more available capacity now on the water. And when we talk about inflation, you know, we're removing some of those costs that are driving inflation.
Because the market, it's super bad, and there's too many people hired, which you can work without them sometimes, you know. And I think that would be bad for everybody, guys. If they start cutting, the big companies start layovering people, I think that means next year will be super tough. It'll be almost impossible to keep it. Like, my loads from LA now is like $2 a mile. My expenses, just for the fuel with reefer, it's a mile per dollar, right? And if you add the extra expenses, I may be making 50 cents as owner of the truck and company and all that stuff right now. 50 cents, guys. Even less than a driver, right? I'm not imagining how another companies, they're gonna survive this kind of economy. But I'm thinking, guys, try to save some money.